Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, Siriana Tarot. This is going to be a love reading for my dearest Virgos. Virgo, we're going to take a look at your past, present, and future. If this reading resonates with you, I'm just going to ask that you like, share, subscribe. Check out the description box for ways you can get a private reading. And if you like the cards that I'm using, I have them listed and linked in order of appearance. Also, feel free to leave a comment and don't forget to ring that notification bell. All right, let's go ahead and jump into this. Let's see what messages come through for my dearest Virgos regarding love and romance. So messages, please, for my Virgos regarding love and romance. All right, so we've got the Emperor, Aries energy. But Virgo, this can also be your energy. This is divine masculine. So either you identify as the divine masculine or you've already met your divine masculine. We see the Nine of Pentacles, beautiful Venus and Virgo energy. So you're looking good. You're feeling good. Virgo, you have bossed up in a big way. Some of you guys, you have your own business or money is just looking good. I feel like there are a lot of people that have eyes on you. In the future, we have the Eight of Cups. There could be somebody who's coming back into your life. Okay, now it could be your divine masculine. It could be your divine feminine. I think they're seeing you very differently, Virgo. That's because you've channeled all this energy into yourself. So we have the Fool. So we have the Fool and the Emperor, Aries energy coming through very strong, or there might be something in the Aries reading for you. Some of you, some of you guys, it's an interesting energy, the Fool and the Emperor here. It's like the whole, it's the Fool's journey. And what I'm seeing, Virgo, I feel like you have bossed up in such a big way. This is a past person that we're dealing with here that's coming in. They maybe made you feel like you weren't good enough in the past, or you didn't feel like you had all of your ducks in a row. I feel like you guys have been really, really focused on your money and on your health. I just think you're a completely different person than you were before. And I think this person's seeing you that way. The Nine of Pentacles and the King of Swords. Absolutely. So what I think in the present, Virgo, this person is definitely coming back to you. I think you've just come into alignment with your true soul's purpose. You're doing what you love. You're absolutely on the right path. This person, I feel like, is watching you. Okay, with the King of Swords. This is somebody who maybe you've started to communicate with, but Virgo, this person is seeing you as their person. I think they're absolutely blown away by you. And we get the Ten of Pentacles and the Eight of Cups in reverse. Yeah, so I feel like Virgo, you've actually met your match here. I feel like both of you could be business owners, or you guys are both very secure. You guys both look good. You both feel good. You both have your ducks in a row. I think, what I'm seeing here with the Ten of Pentacles in reverse is this is somebody who's very, very independent. I'm seeing two single people who have everything that they need, but they don't have each other, or they don't have love, or they don't have marriage, and they don't have commitment. The overall energy, the King of Wands. Some of my Virgos, I'm going to tell it to you straight. You guys are going to tell this person to F off. Okay. Because if they didn't make you feel good in the past, you know, that could be like sort of the reason you're building yourself up, or they didn't make you feel like you had enough money or that you weren't good enough. They're watching you. Their jaw has dropped. It's like this person's drooling because they're seeing you completely differently. They're seeing you for who you truly are, but they may not have wanted to make a commitment to you. I feel like they're coming back in, but they still might be protecting their money. Of course, this could be your energy, Virgo, protecting what you've worked for, and because I see that you've worked very, very hard to go from the Fool to the Emperor. And maybe some of you in a very sort of short period of time, or maybe this is somebody from far off in your past, but you know who you are. And with this King of Swords, if this is somebody that was very in and out of your life, Virgo, I feel like you're going to be very straight up with them. You're going to set very strong boundaries. I don't think you're going to let them just waltz back in. All right. But this person, oof, they've got it bad for you. Absolutely. They're seeing you as their perfect match. But for some of you with this King of Wands, there's a little bit of a warning. This person may be married to somebody else, may be involved with other people. And I kind of get this energy that you're such a catch here, Virgo, that they want to, you know, that it would be like, it would be, you know, the prize on their shelf, right? A notch on their bedpost or whatever, you know, to recapture you or to be with somebody of your caliber. Cause I'm seeing you guys financially doing so well, so well. And I think a lot of my Virgos, you're going to send this person packing. All right, let's see. We've got let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others. So many of you guys, this is a past person who's going to come waltzing back. I think this person did a number on your self-esteem, or they didn't make you feel good enough in the past. I think you had to lean on your friends, you know, and your family. You know, I think you went through a really tough time, to be honest, because this triggered like a huge glow up in you, a huge awakening, you know, just a huge shift from the Fool to the Emperor. I mean, it really doesn't get better than that. I feel like this person maybe, you know, maybe I feel like they're in your energy. They're in your community. They might be asking your friends about you to see if you're single or not. I do think that you're single, but I think you're not going to jump into a situation with just anybody, and particularly this person. Okay. This person wants to come in and they want to work on this partnership. Like I said, Virgo, I'm a little bit uncomfortable because we have the King of Wands and the Three of Cups here. So this person, I feel like, is going to be coming in to ask you out on a date or to hook up or to come, you know, to talk or whatever that might be. But they're coming in as the King of Wands. They still might want to stay single. And with the Three of Cups energy, you have to make sure that they're not in another connection. Okay. So don't rush into this, but I don't see you rushing into it. I feel like they're the ones that want to rush into it. With the Star card under here, you could be dealing with an Aquarius. This could be a wish fulfilled for you. And for some of you guys, I mean, you know, the message here is shifting a little bit, that it's safe for you to love this person. Okay. I do feel like with that, with the King of Wands, you know, this is somebody here who may be trying to manifest you, or you've been trying to manifest it. It may make you very happy that they come in and they want to work on things. So again, trust your intuition here, Virgo. But I also feel like with it's safe for you to love, you're ready for love. Okay. But if this was an unrequited love situation in the past and there was separation, the real deal is absolutely worth waiting for. And for some of you guys, you might not even... I'm just getting, for some of you guys, this past person, they are going to come back in. This is your wish fulfillment. They're going to want to come in and work on things, but you're going to tell it to them straight, Virgo, because you're not the same person. You have bossed up. You've been through this major glow up physically and financially is what I'm seeing. You're in your strength. You're in your power. And if somebody comes in just sort of like not wanting to, you know, share their life, or they don't want to share their feelings, or they want to stay single, but they want you as some sort of prize, that you're going to be, I'm okay waiting. You know, I have everything I need. Okay. I have everything I need, and I don't need somebody who's going to be in and out of my life. So just be aware of that, Virgo. We get my beloved, though we may be physically apart, spiritually, we're always united. For love transcends space and time. Nothing is missing. All right. And then we get twin flames. All right. So some of my Virgos, you guys are on a twin flame journey, and spirit does want me to recognize that for some of you guys, you are going to give this person a second chance. This may be their past energy, or they might not be ready for commitment because I feel like they're trying to protect their money and everything they've built up. And they also want to see how far you've come, who you really are. They're going to be sussing you out as much as you're sussing them out. If it's a twin flame journey, you guys may have already gone through that separation period, okay? And this is what your person, they're manifesting you. Though we may be physically apart, spiritually, we're always united. Nothing is missing. Hey, let's make this work. Let's make this happen. All right. Now, for others of you, if this person comes in as the King of Wands in reverse, and they're in and out and they've got other options and they're not serious and they're not looking for the same things that you absolutely are going to tell this person, you know what? I'm looking for somebody who's going to offer me safety, security, stability. They're going to make me feel good. And I'm okay waiting for that. I'm okay waiting, because Virgo, you have it all. You absolutely do. All right, I'm going to leave it there. I'm sending you lots of love and light. Take care.